Chinese smokestacks put out more carbon dioxide than any other countries, more even than the world's largest economy, the United States. So Wednesday's announcement by U.S. President Barack Obama and Chinese President Xi Jinping was significant, says Duke University climate policy expert Tim Profeta.
You cannot solve this problem with the U.S. and China alone, but there's no way you're going to solve this problem without the U.S. and China taking action.
Xi pledged for the first time that China's emissions would peak in 2030. The country aims to get 20% of its energy needs from zero-carbon sources by then. That would mean adding more renewable energy than the country currently generates from coal-fired power plants. President Obama committed to cut U.S. emissions by about a quarter below 2005 levels by 2025. The White House says that's double the current pace of reduction.
This is an ambitious goal, but it is an achievable goal.
But it's a goal that would face opposition from incoming leaders of Congress, including likely Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell.
As I read the agreement, requires the Chinese to do nothing at all for 16 years while these carbon emission regulations are creating havoc in my state and other states around the country.
Even if both sides reach their targets, this deal alone will not be enough to avert dramatic climate change impacts, Profeta says.
You can't look at the numbers here and think, well, this will satisfy our need to reduce greenhouse gases over the next century. The significance of this step is that these two countries are taking steps to get on the right trajectory and hopefully will inspire and accelerate action in the future.
Experts hope the U.S.-China agreement will result in progress on a global deal at the upcoming climate summit in Peru in December. Steve Barragona, VOA News, Washington.